Bueno, sí.
Hey guys, Harsh here and welcome back to Technoloop. This is the iPhone SE 2020. I have been using this phone as my daily phone for about a month and I have a couple of thoughts that I want to share with you guys today. So this is my full review of the iPhone SE 2020. Sit back, relax and enjoy. Alright, let's start by talking about one of the most controversial aspects about this phone, and that is the design. Yes, the design is almost 5 years old. This design was first introduced with the iPhone 6, it got carried over to the iPhone 6s, 7, 8 and now finally brought back in 2020 with the iPhone SE. There's no denying that the design is old, this phone looks old, does not look like a modern phone at all. I totally get that point, and if you cannot get past the design, then stop the video right over here. Because if you cannot get past the design, you are not going to like this phone no matter what I say. But if you can get past the design, then the iPhone SE has a lot to offer, and I think that it is a very good phone in a lot of areas. That's why if you can get past the design, then continue with this video. So once I got past that design, there's one thing that really impressed me with this phone, and that is the performance. This phone comes with the latest A13 Bionic chipset inside it. The same chipset which is present in the iPhone 11 series is available in the iPhone SE as well. A13 Bionic chipset is literally one of the best out there, and this phone performs like a champ. No matter what you throw at it, the iPhone SE will handle it easily. Even games like PUBG, you can play at HDR extreme settings and you will have no, frame drops whatsoever. You will have a couple of frame drops here and there, but nothing major. You can play the game at HDR extreme. In fact, I've done a dedicated PUBG review of this phone on my Hindi channel. In case you missed that video, it will be linked in the I button over here and also in the description box below. So you can go ahead and check out that video if you want to see the PUBG performance on this phone. A big part of performance is also software. This phone comes with iOS 13 out of the box, and it will get the latest iOS 14 update as well. In fact, I have installed the beta version of iOS 14 on this phone, and even that works really well. It is surprising how stable the beta version is for iOS 14, and that's just excellent. But apart from iOS 14, the iOS 13 version that you will get out of the box, the stable one, is very good. The software optimization is in fact pretty good, and Apple has done a good job with optimizing the software on this phone. Overall, in terms of performance, this phone is a champ and literally one of the best out there in its price segment. Next up, let's talk about that display. This phone comes with a pretty small 4.7 inch display, which is an IPS LCD panel, and it is 720p, a little over 720p. I know these numbers do not look great on paper, but trust me, the display quality is actually very good. There are huge bezels on the display on the top and bottom, but those bezels won't matter to you after a couple of days. Like, these bezels did not bother me after a couple of days. It does take some time to get used to those bezels because, come on, we are used to phones which have literally no bezels. That's why it takes some time, but after you start using the phone, you will realize that the display quality is actually pretty good. The colors are accurate, the viewing angles are great, and it also gets bright enough to use in outdoor sunny conditions. So there are absolutely no problems with the panel quality. In fact, it is one of the best LCD panels out there. Alright, now let's talk about one more controversial aspect about this phone, that is battery life. A lot of reviewers out there said that the battery is really bad, it is straight up trash, and you should not buy this phone because of the battery life. Well, I do not agree with that point. The battery life has been pretty good for me. I'm not saying that it is the battery champ, but it is not bad either. I was easily getting through the day with 10 to 15% battery left at night. Now, I know my use might not be the most heavy use out there, but for a normal user, the battery is sufficient and you will easily get through the day. If you ask in terms of screen on time, I was getting somewhere around 4.5 hours of screen on time, which is pretty good according to me for a phone this small. So remember, this is a compact and handy phone, and for a phone this size, the battery life is actually not bad. Now when it comes to charging, this phone has wireless charging and also wired charging. Wireless charging is a very big pro of this phone because wireless charging is very convenient. So if you want to use wireless charging with this phone, you can do that, and that is a plus point. Talking about plus points, the iPhone SE is also IP67 rated. That means it has protection from water and dust, and that is a very handy feature. So right now it's the monsoon season in my city and it's raining continuously. I don't have to worry about my phone getting damaged in the rain because of the IP67 rating. I can just pick up my phone in the rain and answer any calls that I have, or I can use my phone in the rain without being worried about my phone getting damaged. So the IP67 rating gets a big fat thumbs up from my side. The iPhone SE brings back Touch ID. Touch ID works really well on the iPhones. It is super fast, very accurate, and I wish that Apple somehow implements under display fingerprint sensors in their next iPhone, because Apple is very good at making fingerprint sensors and it works really well on the iPhone SE as well. And now with the whole pandemic situation, we are wearing masks and we know how that works with iPhone, 11 or the ones which has Face ID. That really sucks. That's why it is beneficial to have Touch ID, especially when you're wearing a mask. And in case if you're not wearing a mask, then please wear a mask. It is very important. If you wear a mask, it will prove that you're a smart person. Now let's talk about the main pro with this phone, and that is the camera. The iPhone SE has a single rear camera, and this is a prime example of the fact that you don't need multiple cameras to have a great camera experience. This phone has a single rear camera and it shoots some really awesome photos. I would say it shoots 99% same photos as the iPhone 11. The dynamic range is excellent. There is a good amount of detail in the photos. The colors are natural, not too oversaturated, not too undersaturated. And overall, this phone can shoot really awesome photos. It's a reliable camera. I can trust this camera to shoot good photos 99% of the times. In fact, I have made a dedicated camera review of the iPhone SE 2020, and if you want to watch that video, then it will be linked in the I button over here and also in the description box below. That video has a lot more details and a lot more sample pictures as well. iPhone SE is also the best phone in its price segment for shooting videos. It can shoot up to 60fps in 4K, and the video quality is just amazing. We all know how well the iPhone 11 performs, and well, the iPhone SE performs similarly in terms of daylighting conditions. So it shoots some really good videos, and you can definitely buy it if you are planning to start a YouTube channel, or maybe if you want to use this phone for shooting videos for any purpose that you might have. So when it comes to shooting videos, the iPhone SE does not disappoint at all. Overall, for the price of ₹38,000, the iPhone SE has a lot to offer if and only if you get past the design. That is a very important step. You have to get over the design flaw, and then only you will like this phone. So if you get past that, you are going to have one hell of an experience and you will absolutely love the iPhone SE. I would call this phone a baby iPhone 11. I'm going to leave it there. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Harsh Punjabi, and I'll see you guys in the next one.